Good morning everyone, welcome to Narayan online video classes. Today for class 7 students under the topic logarithms, we are going to solve few more problems based on laws of logarithms. In our previous class we have seen some important laws, three basic laws. One is law of addition, second one law of subtraction, third one is law of powers we have seen. In addition to that, we have seen few more important results which are used to solve problems related to logarithms. Today we solve few more problems based on those laws. If you look at the first question, the simplest form of log root 27 to the base 10 plus log 8 to the base 10 plus log root over 1000 to the base 10 upon log 120 to the base 10, what is the value? We are given four options: 1/2, 1/3, 3/2, and 2/3. Let us solve it. Solution, let us take. The given is log root 27 to the base 10 plus log 8 to the base 10 plus log root 1000 to the base 10 upon log 120 to the base 10. That is equal to log root 27. If you prime factorize 27, that will be 3 cube. So it is root 27, so we can write it as 3 cube to the power of 1/2. Let us write it: log 3 cube to the power of 1/2 to the base 10 plus log 2 cube to the base 10 plus log, if you look at that, 1000. 1000 is nothing but 10 cube. If you want to take, that is 10 cube in the sense, we can write it as 10 to the power of 3/2 to the base 10 upon log 120. 120, if you write, that is equal to log 2 cube times of 3 into 5. Let us write it: 2 cube times of 3 into 5 to the base 10. If you further simplify that, that is going to be 3/2 log 3 to the base 10. If you look at that, 3/3/2. So we are using the power rule, so that 3/2 log 3 to the base 10 will be the resultant. Now plus here also you can write 3 log 2 to the base 10 plus here we can write it as 3/2 log 10 to the base 10 upon, here if you look at that, we can write here, it is something like 2 cube, I try to take it as, because we have 2 cube into 3 into 5 to the base 10, we have to use the very first law of logarithms, that is law of multiplication, product law, or law of addition also we will call it as. So if you can split like that, that is going to be, here what I am going to do is 2 cube I will write as 2 square into 2, 1 2 I will multiply with 5. So look at this, it is something like log 2 square to the base 10 plus log 3 to the base 10 plus, if I take 2 times 5, that is log 10 to the base 10. Okay, because log 10 to the base 10 is 1. So now the my next step will be 3/2 times log 3 to the base 10 plus 3 log 2 to the base 10 plus, it will be 3/2 upon, here if you look at that, it is 2 log 2 to the base 10 plus it is log 3 to the base 10 plus 1. So we have to make sure that the terms in the numerator and terms in the denominator are same with some numerical coefficient difference. So if you can convert like that, we can cancel the corresponding terms. Let us try to see whether we got that form or not. Now that is going to be, suppose here log 3/2, if I take common, what I am going to have here, here it will be log 3 to the base 10 plus here 3/2, if you take common, it becomes 2 log 2 to the base 10 plus, it will be 1 upon, if you look at the denominator, that is log 2 log 2 to the base 10 plus log 3 to the base 10 plus 1. If you observe here, this term and this term both are nothing but the same. So these two will be cancelled. The resultant answer will be 3/2 or 3/2. So the third option is the right answer for us. Now let us move to the next question. The second question is, express two log 5 root 5 to the base 10 plus 3 log 2 to the base 10 minus log 50 to the base 10 minus 1 as a single logarithm. We are asked to convert it as a single logarithm. Let us solve it. What you have? 2 log 5 root 5 to the base 10 plus 3 log 2 to the base 10 minus log 50 to the base 10 minus 1. Okay, now if you take this one, 1 I can write as log 10 to the base 10, so that I can ensure that in each term we have a log with base 10. So that then, even here if you look at that, 2 log 5 root 5 to the base 10, if I take this 2 to the power position, it will be 5 root 5 whole square. So 5 root 5 whole square to the base 10 plus it will be log 2 cube to the base 10 minus log 50 to the base 10 minus, I can write 1 as log 10 to the base 10, because log a to the base a is always 1, where a is not equal to 1, of course. That is otherwise log 5 root 5 whole square is 5 square is 25. 25 into root 5 whole square is 5. 25 times 5, that is 125 to the base 10 plus this is log 8 to the base 10 minus half, let me write it as 50 to the base 10 plus log 10 to the base 10. Now I will apply the first law of logarithms, that is law of addition. In that case we get it as these two terms, if you consider log 125 times 8 to the base 10 minus log, this will be 50 times 10 to the base 10. Now if you look at these two, we can apply the second law of logarithms. Here we have applied third law of logarithms, that is law of powers. Here we are applying law of addition. Now we are going to apply law of subtraction. The three laws are used in this particular problem. In this case, what do you get? Log 125 times 8 by 50 times 10 to the base 10, because as you have minus sign, that is going to be log, if you do the simplification, 2 25s and 5 25s, okay, 2 4s, 5 cancels here 2 times, so 2 times it will cancel. So the answer will be log 2 to the base 10. This is how we can solve this particular question. So in this problem, if you look at, we have used the three laws of logarithms. Fine, now let us move to the next question. The next question is, find the value of log 49 to the base 343 into log 125 to the base 625. This is what he is asking us to find out. Let us start this part. What is given? Log 49 to the base 343 into log 125 to the base 625. Now 49 we can write as log 7 square. 343 is 7 cube times log 125 is 5 cube, 625 is 5 to the power of 4. Okay, so we have prime factorized the given arguments as well as the basis. Now we have one rule, that is log a to the power of n to the base b to the power of n is equal to m by n times log a to the base b. Log a to the power of m to the base b to the power of n is m by n times log a to the base b. That rule we are going to use here. That is going to be 2 by 3 log 7 to the base 7 into log, into here also we can write it as 3 by 4 times log 5 to the base 5. Okay, that is going to be, if you look at this result and this result, both are equal to 1. Log a base a is always 1, where a is not equal to 1, and a is positive real number. Therefore, we can say 2 by 3 times 3 by 4 will be the resultant answer. This is 1 and this is 1. Okay. So that is going to be 3, 3 cancels and 2 1s and 2 2s. So the answer will be 1 by 2 for this particular question. So here we are applying the law. Log a power n to the base b power n is m by n times log a to the base b. Based on that formula, we could be able to solve this problem. Now we move to the next problem. The next problem is, find the value of That is the question for us. Now, let us solve it. What is given? Log 3 to the base 2 into log 4 to the base 3 into log 5 to the base 4 into so on into log 64 to the base 63. Now we have one rule. That rule is, if at all you have log a to the base b, we can write it as log a to the base m upon log b to the base m. Okay, m can be any non-negative real number. Okay, so other than one. Next, so that we'll split it in this way: log 3 to the base 10 by log 2 to the base 10 into log 4 to the base 10 by log 3 to the base 10 into so on into log 64 to the base 10 by log 63 to the base 10. We can convert in that way using this formula. Now, here if you look at that, these two terms cancel, this and this term cancel, and here the terms will cancel. Then what is remaining now? And then we have log 64 to the base 10 by log 2 to the base 10. That is otherwise log 64 to the base 2. Okay? Because this can be actually written as log 64 to the base 2. That is going to be log 64 is 2 to the power of 6. 64 is 2 to the power of 6 to the base 2. So it is going to be 6 times log 2 to the base 2. That is going to be 6 times 1, that is 6, because log 2 to the base 2 is equal to 1. So what is the rule we have used in this particular problem? We use log a to the base b as log a to the base m by log b to the base m. Then again, log a base a is equal to 1. These two particular rules we have used in solving this particular question. Now we'll move to the next one. The next problem is, find the value of 1 by log xy to the base x plus 1 by log xy to the base y. Now let us see the solution. We have 1 by log xy to the base x plus 1 by log xy to the base y. In this form we cannot solve it because both are having different bases and it is difficult to solve in this particular form. So what to do? Here I will use this particular rule now. If you have log a to the base b, that can be written as 1 by log b to the base a. Base and argument will be interchanged if you write it in its denominator position. Okay. Now based on that, if you can see this, it can be written as log x to the base xy plus log y to the base xy. Using this particular rule, I have converted it in this way. That is otherwise, if you look at that, both have the same basis. Okay, with different arguments, fine. Now I can use the first law of logarithms, that is log x to the base a plus log y to the base a is equal to log xy to the base a. So that is otherwise log xy to the base xy. So we know that log xy to the base xy value is always 1, provided xy is not 1 and product of x and y is a positive real number. So this is how we can solve it. So while solving this problem, what is the rule we are using? Log a to the base b is 1 by log b to the base a. Using that, we could be able to solve this particular question. Now we'll move to the next one. The next problem is, if a is equal to 2 pi root over l upon g, then find log a. Okay, how to find out log a if at all you are given a as that? Solution, let us take a is equal to 2 pi into under root of l by z. Let us apply logarithm on both the sides, that is log a is equal to log 2 pi into under root of l by z. Okay, if here base is not mentioned, don't worry, that is need not mention every time, it is then considered. So that is equal to log, we can apply the first rule, log 2 pi, or we can write log 2 plus log pi plus log root over l by z. First, let us apply the first rule. The next, log 2 plus log pi plus, if you look at l by z, root of l by z, it is l by z whole power 1 by 2. So it can be written as half times log l by z. Still further, we can simplify that. How to do that? Log 2 plus log pi plus half. This is in the form of log of x by y. So that is log L minus log Z. So here we are using the first law, and in this case we are using the second law, and here of course we are using the third law even. Even in solving this particular question, we are using the three important laws of logarithm. Okay, one is addition, law of addition, law of subtraction, as well as law of power. So all the three rules we have used in solving this particular question. This is the final form of the given question. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you.